Hey everyone, I've just signed up for Google Gemini AI for my company Terrific and the Google Workspace. So I wanted to test it out. I've been using ChatGPT for a while, but I've pretty much never used Gemini. So I thought it would be nice to see how it works and see if I can use it for a specific case. So to begin with, what I'm going to aim to do today is I'd like to create a few example social media posts and then show you how to set it up in HubSpot with a bulk import. And so we're going to start. I haven't really used Gemini much before, so this is going to be sort of a fresh exploration together. What I want to do is I want to start by creating 10 social media posts, which include an interesting, let's say each includes an interesting fact about digital marketing and if possible, HubSpot and Zapier. Let's see what it comes up with. Cool. Looks great. 10 social media posts packed with digital marketing facts. Okay. 80% of marketers use visual assets in their social media and includes some hashtags as well. Fun fact, email marketing offers one of the highest ROIs across marketing channels. Content marketing generates 3 times as many leads as traditional marketing. Over half of all web traffic happens on mobile devices. Great. Okay, so now I'm going to ask it, can you add this to a spreadsheet and include a schedule for posting 3 times a day? Cool. Okay, this is great. So we've got the post number, the column for the fact we're putting in, and a column for attaching or including an image, and then column D for the timing. And then we can export this straight to Google Sheets. Let's try it. Amazing. Okay, without going into too much detail here, well, actually, we need some images. So let's try and generate some images. I'll delete this first row here, and then let's try Gemini for some images. Can you generate image for each of your posts? Okay, interesting. So it's described the images. I don't know if it can do an actual image. Let's see. Can you make? Okay. It's doing it. Cool. So it was adding it in text first. I think I might have messed up the first one maybe. And then it's done it for the next ones. Some of the next ones. Okay, let's try it again. Can do it again, but make the images seem magical. Okay, it's tried a bit. I don't know what happened with the other posts, but we have 2, 3, 4. So I'm going to start it instead. I'm going to say, can you generate an original image, which is of a magician doing magic in space surrounded by robots? Okay, it looks like it's not doing images at the moment because of all the problems with it generating a range of historically inaccurate images recently in the news. So it looks like we can't do any images here. That's why maybe we're only stuck with these 3 pretty boring ones. But okay, let's work with these. So let's download these images. Actually, let me see if I can open the images in a new window. Let's try this. And if we can get a URL. I'm not sure if this is going to be a public URL. Okay, I've added this to an incognito window and it seems to work. So then let's try this. Okay, we're going to drop this in. Actually, now that I look at it, it looks like the whole text hasn't come through in the Google Sheet. That's also quite interesting. So let's drop these URLs in first. We've got our facts here, but the dots, it hasn't, the whole message hasn't come through in the Google Sheet. Let's see, like that. Okay, so it's given me an example, but it's not actually adding it into a spreadsheet. So let me see if I can pull it all together. So can you combine your previous messages so that I have a spreadsheet with the top 10 social posts and also some images? Okay, it looks like we've still got the dots. Let's try again. And we got the dots. Same problem. We do have the image descriptions, which is nice. Try the sheet. The table doesn't have the full post included. Fix this. Okay, so now it's helping me fix it, but it's just giving me an example of how I could fix it. So it's not very useful. So I'm just going to copy paste it in this case because I don't have time to try and work this out for this video. Let's just pull this straight in because I want to get to the point where we can upload it to HubSpot as well. So we'll close this one. We're going going to just do a demo here. So we'll pop this in, grab the next one, pop it in, and third one, pop that in too. Great. Okay, now we're going to jump into HubSpot, and we're going to go to marketing and social, and we're going to schedule in bulk. So to schedule in bulk, you can upload a spreadsheet or a CSV file, and we can have a look at the template now. Just have a quick look at that. And I'm going to import that to Google Docs just so we can open it here. Sheets.new. And then I can just go like this, import. And I grab that, drop that in. Replace spreadsheet. Cool. So this is what we get as our template. We've got account. Okay. So we're going to start by adding to LinkedIn. We can do a few actually. So we've got account, we've got date, message, link, photo, et cetera, et cetera. Okay, cool. So let's grab that in. I'm just going to pull this in here just to make it a bit faster for us. And then we're going to say, we're going to grab these posts. They're our messages. We're not going to have a link, but we'll grab the images and we'll put that here under photo URL. And we'll leave the rest blank. Oh, we can see here the number of letters, the character count. Okay. And so we've got our account. Let's drop these all on LinkedIn. We'll just go with what we've got here for the times. I think that should be fine. Let's keep those. And then let's also copy this, and we'll do the same for Facebook as well, so we can just see how this all looks. Paste that there, and I'm just going to get rid of everything we don't need. And we can say that this is the social schedule. And I'm going to export this as a CSV, download CSV. And now we've downloaded CSV, we can drag it into here, click upload. So this is what I'm demonstrating here is the schedule in bulk feature. Yesterday, I did another video on how you can set up your own spreadsheet and using Zapier just automatically update. So you don't even have to run through this scheduling sort of process as well. So check out that video if you haven't already. And now we get our posts here. I'm not sure the image doesn't seem to have loaded. Let's open it up. It doesn't look like the image worked. Maybe because the URL doesn't really work. Let's have a quick look. Okay, it seems to. Let me just save this in anyway. And then we can drop our images in instead. Okay, I'm uploading these images into my HubSpot account. And then we can pull them in, oops, like this. So we'll grab our dollar image. Let's have a look at that. So we've got our new dollar image here. Got our other uploaded ones. So we can just move all of these into drafts. We can schedule them all straight up. If we were to upload with a link to an image that worked, then this part would be faster. Let's go back. We can go under images, we can go to file like this. And so instead, let's just say move all to draft. Now we've got our posts in draft, and let's add in image here. Cool. And so we can see here how it would look. And then once we've got our posts all set up the way we want them, we can essentially select the ones we want. We've got to keep an eye on when we're planning to post them, publish them here. And then when it's ready, we can schedule, we can approve the draft, review the posts. We've got our two posts here, one, two. Check everything's fine. Check the schedule is good. And then we can click schedule. And then these posts are scheduled, as we can see, like so. So it's very easy. I think Gemini seems like it's still got a lot of room to improve. It's all about learning, I guess, the right way to prompt it. And I'm sure it's still a work in progress. I like the fact that you can jump straight in and export to Google Sheets like this, but obviously it's not even generating the content. It's more just like an example. So there's still quite a few steps away from being really smooth process, but I'm sure, I guess it does a few steps, which is good. So that's it for this video. Just a little bit of an exploration around Gemini and bulk uploading to HubSpot. Let me know what you think, if this is useful, if you want me to explore a little bit more around Gemini workspaces, I think I'd like to do that, or anything else, please jump into the comments and share there. Otherwise, look forward to seeing you in the next video. Okay, cheers. Bye.